Human's action with Allah's actions. You with me? When you compare human's action with Allah's action, you are falling into clear misguidance. And that is exactly what happened with Al-Qadariya. The reason the Qadariya deviated, because they start resembling and judging Allah's action based upon human action. No. Allah's actions is based upon wisdom and justice and mercy. Sometimes you know the purpose behind it. Sometimes you don't know. But we know, based upon the proofs and evidences, Allah is the all-wise, the just, the most merciful. And I always mention this story of the best stories in the Quran about Musa. Musa and who? And Al-Khidr. So Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, as we mentioned in the hadith of Sahih Bukhari, he was asked by the Israelites. They said, "Ya Musa, man a'lam man fil ard? Who is the most knowledgeable person upon the earth?" Musa is the messenger of Allah. So he said, "Me." So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala corrected him. And he said, "Next time say, Allah knows best." He said, "I will send you to someone that has more knowledge than you in some affairs." So he met with the Khidr. What was the Khidr? Al-Khidr, first action what he did. He was traveling with Musa. Then they had to cross from the river, from one side to the other side. So young boys who were working in the river, they said to Musa, "We will help you by using our boats to cross from one side to the other side." So when they did help them, what happened? Musa, Khidr, he scratched the boat of the two young boys. They were poor. Musa said, "What an evil thing." He said, "These people, young children or young boys, have helped us to cross from one side to the other side." So he said, "Oh Musa, do you remember I said you cannot be patient with me?" He said, "Do not blame me, I forgot." So Musa carry on with Al-Khidr. What happened? They saw a young boy playing. What Al-Khidr did, went and killed him. And that young boy was not a baby, as a Christian tried to utilize Samuel when he said in the Bible, kill the babies. No. That young boy, he was killed. Why? I have to explain why, okay? Not because his father did something or his grandfather did something, no. So the young boy was killed. Musa said, "What are you killing the young boy for? Innocent person." He said, "You know, I told you you're gonna be patient." Then the third one, they went to the inside the village, they asked the people of the village to host them, and they rejected. And they helped two young men to fix the wall. And Musa said, "Your affair is very, very strange. Those who helped us, you did this and that to them. Those who doesn't want to help us, you aid them and help them." He said, "This is the final destiny of me. But let me explain to you. The first young boy, so what's happening here? Let me clarify, what's happening here? Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, as the scholars mentioned, he is judging Al-Khidr's action from outside, from the apparent. You with me? But Al-Khidr, he has the knowledge of the inward, the purpose behind it. So Al-Khidr said, the two young boys who helped us, they were a king in the area, he will take any boat that is good. So I scratched it in order for the king to not take their boat, because they were utilizing it to make money from it, okay? Second one, the young boy, he was gonna grow up as an evil person. Not a young boy, he was killed because his father did something or his great-great-grandfather did something, no. Because himself, he was gonna grow up as an evil person, okay? As for the third situation, those young men, their father was a righteous man and he left a treasure for them under the wall. So my point here, akhi, when Al-Khidr alayhi salatu wasalam and Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, Musa start criticizing him based upon the outside action. Then Al-Khidr clarified to him, everything what he did, there's a wisdom behind it. And for example, as I've mentioned this example many times, if you and I will see someone from far away cutting off someone's forearm, we're gonna think he's a crazy man. He's mentally disturbed. But when we get there, he says, "No, I'm a doctor. And this guy has a deadly disease in his forearm. If you leave it, it will spread to his body and he will die." What about Allah's actions? If this is just what Allah has shown us, if this is just a human's actions, we can misjudge them easily. What about the actions of the Most High, the All-Wise? Does that make sense? Is that clear?
So I don't think when you say the Christian, they could say, "Yeah, but the Trinity is
a single thing." No, the Qadr of Allah does not go against intellect. Does not go against natural inclination. When we said secret of Allah, sometimes what he means, as Sheikh Saleh al-Sheikh, may Allah preserve him, mentioned, he said secret of Allah means do not indulge in thinking about it too much. We understand that the Qadr of Allah, there's four maratib, four levels. Allah knew it. Then Allah written down in the preserved tablet. Then Allah created it. Then Allah willed it. Khalas, we understand that. I understand that if I'm going to not have a free will to go to my house, or to go where, or to go to nightclub, or to go where, or to go to a fanfare, I have a free will. I'm not going to end up in a place when they're smoking drugs, killing each other, and they say, Allah, oh, they created it for me. No, you're cut them. Likewise, as Ibn Taymiyyah said, no one will be happy for me to come and rob you, take your money, and I said, don't complain, Allah has decreed this for me to rob you. You're not going to accept that. He said, no, let me call the police. The way Allah has decreed for you to rob you, then Allah has decreed for me to call the police too. You understand? So all of us, we are inside the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the decree of Allah does not go, the qadr of Allah does not go against intellect. But Trinity, God does not change. God is perfect. But what? God became a baby. Someone had to change his nappy. Someone had to breastfeed him. What, the secret of Allah? This doesn't make any sense. Because, you know, let me want to clarify something, and I hope that you make it as a separate video. The Christians always say to us, if God is able to do everything, why can he not become a man? It's a good question, sir. If God can do everything, why he cannot become a man? This is a tricky question. What they did, they ask you about God's actions, then the other question, they said what? No, they tell you what God does, then they ask you about what God is. There's difference between what God is and what God does. God does whatever he wishes according to his wisdom. What God is does not change. For example, is it logical, rational to say, God is all-knowing if he wants to? God's essence and his that, which is the attribute that is connected to his essence, does not change. If he got against his nature to become imperfect, he cannot be the same God who is perfect all the times. You see? So when you say God become a man, that is a paradox. Because a man is imperfect all the time. God is perfect all the times. So combine between the two. You know, it doesn't make any sense, correct? So God is perfect all the times. Human is imperfect all the time. But God is a man at the same time. It's like someone telling you, God exists if he wants to. No, by definition, God has no beginning, no end. And that's why how you answer it. Say, no, there's a difference between what God is and what God does. What God is does not change. God is all-knowing, correct? All the times. God is all-truthful, all the times. God is powerful, all the times. God has no beginning, no end, all the times. You see? So that's what God is. Understand? What God does, God spoke to Moses, he never spoke to me. He spoke to Prophet Muhammad, he never spoke to Intisar. Understand? So what God is different than what God does. You understand? So when a Christian asks you that, said, do you believe God changed? He said, you know. Because if God become imperfect, it is impossible for him to be the same God who is perfect all the times. So Christianity doesn't make any sense. However, there is two types of Christians out there. Some of them, they don't know, they're ignorant. And when you explain to them, they will accept Islam. Some of them are stubborn, they follow their forefathers, and they know it doesn't make any sense. You know. Is that clear? Barakallahu feekum, hayyakum Allah. Jazakumullah, feekum, salam
alaykum. Shamsi,
salam alaykum. Alaykum, salam alaykum. Alhamdulillah, how are you doing, Baba? You good, ask family?
I'm good, alhamdulillah.
You good, yeah?
I'm all right. I came from United States to grow.
United States. You know what I call it? I call it United Snakes.
Nah,
yeah. There's a brother. There's a Muslim, they're
love
with you.
His brother, bro. He's in love with you. I'm watching
this. What, from Bosnia?
Yeah, from Bosnia.
Akhi, do you know the brothers from Bosnia, Albania, mashallah, from the other country?
Kosovo.
Uzbekistan, Akhi.
Uzbekistan,
mashallah. Yeah, mashallah. The brothers, mashallah, they love the deen and they love them in America. There's a lot in America, mashallah.
I used to live here, but then I moved there because I got married.
But this is United States. How the five the Muslims there? It was good.
You know, before I went...
It's a nice country, America, man.
Yeah, you know, before I went, and everybody was telling me, don't go because there's a lot of racism.
Yeah.
Subhanallah.